My name is Emerson Rain. So good to have you back. And today we will be doing some relaxation and inspiration. Today we're going to be looking at some art books I have for you here. And we're going to begin with sure you like and subscribe if you'd like to see more. So let's get these cards and their box. Okay. Try to shuffle. Message is the inspiration and the lessons that we can learn from this artist. So, I'm going to pick a card. From the card first. It says, breathing is secondary. Don't forget to think. A good manifesto is foremost legible. Reconsider your concept of small versus big. Okay. Now, I'm going to open up the guidebook. I'm going to read the message that it has. Where he was a Pritzker Prize winning architect, Rem Koolhaas was a journalist and writer hailed for his retroactive Manhattan Manifesto, Delirious New York, 1972. Founder of architecture firm OMA and its research branch AMO, Rem mixes his practice with fashion, literature, controversial ideas about the modern world. With graphic designer Bruce Mao, Koolhaas published SMLXL in 1995, a landmark tome that blends literary genres to present OMA projects and philosophies. Koolhaas' office is like a fertility clinic for talent, having produced some of the most innovative, in-demand architects working today. So, I used to read these cards while I was taking a painting course. And they used to give me some inspiration, something to focus on for each lesson. Perhaps an artist you haven't heard of before. And you can look into their art for some inspiration. Okay. Put this away. Witches and Wicked Bodies. So first, this cover drew me in so much. It's so beautiful. The artwork here, the detailing and everything. It's gorgeous. And, of course, I could not resist the title of Witches and Art. I really love the depiction of the unnatural acts of flying, witches' sabbath and devilish rituals, unholy trinities and the weird sisters of Macbeth, magical circles, incantations and raising the dead, and the persistence of witches. My hair is on this book, I'm sorry. So withered and so wild in their attire, that look not like the inhabitants of the earth, and yet are on it. Banquo in Shakespeare's Macbeth. So, through the preface, we have another gorgeous illustration. Beautiful, look at his paths, this ink. Monster. 1938. It's weird, like, kind of the face kind of looks like early Lucian Freud when he had those kind of weird, like, flat looking faces that were exaggerated. It's really interesting. The candles and the trees. This looks so much fun. Dancing skeletons, 1934. Seeing the actual paint that he used, his so real, like he didn't exist too long ago. Creative and at the same time very mentally ill. So I think this is something, his story is something that a lot of artists relate to. All of this brushwork in the back, I mean, it's just one simple color, but he's made it like so alive with these strokes. Stunning. I love this. I love this. This is the yellow house. Oh, it's beautiful. This is, I think this is an album cover for Yellow House, the band as well, which is also a band that I love. You should check them out. Of course, sunflowers. Oh, and this painting. Masterpieces in the Brooklyn Museum. And it's interesting to see where he got his inspiration from. I know as well he had like a lot of inspiration from Japan at one point, which I found like really interesting. He used to buy like magazines or books from there, and he would paint some of the covers. Vincent, his self-portraits are my favorite. Two were so close. There was a book in the museum as well, and a collection of their letters, and I began to read it when I was in the store, and it made me so emotional. I felt like I wouldn't be able to handle reading all of it, because it would just be too sad. Here's this early years artist. It's so stunning. Like a myself here than in the north. I even work in the wheat fields at midday, in the full heat of the sun, without any shade whatever. And there you are. I revel in it like a cicada. He's a beautiful writer, too. Yes, I love the sketch of the sower. It's just like so oddly eccentric. Painted, I would have had to kill it, and that would have been a shame, since the animal is so beautiful, he wrote to his brother. He later decided to paint this picture, after all, based on the drawing. He is such a gentle soul. Love how he appreciated nature. Pencil, brush, and oil paint in watercolor on paper. Yeah, I like looking at them more like I guess incomplete looking work. I don't know, it feels more human, you know. See you.